When filmmakers use a piece of popular music in their movies, it's referred to as a needle drop. The phrase originated in the music industry to describe when an album was transferred from a vinyl record to digital audio. It eventually made its way into film as a slang term for when a popular song is placed strategically in a scene. The right song can do a lot of good. The wrong song at the wrong moment,
whatever happened to our love,
can be disastrous. Make sure to subscribe and click the bell icon to stay in the loop.
Well, I don't know why I came here tonight. I got the feeling of something right.
Adding your own needle drops can have an indelible imprint on the audience. The first thing you need to do is consider the scene's tone.
Let's go do some damage.
You may set out to create a funny scene.
Friday night, it was late. What the hell is that? LRB, Little River Band.
This music makes me feel like I'm going shopping for a training bra.
Or a scene with a more sinister tone. Or even detached irony.
It can work!
We'll meet again.
All of these are valid as long as you're certain about what you want your audience to feel at that moment. Let's look at this scene from American Psycho.
You're about to kill a lot of people!
It's time to feel good.
You like Huey Lewis on the news?
They're okay.
Their early work was a little too new wave for my taste. But when Sports came out in 83, I think they really came into their own, commercially and artistically.
Patrick Bateman has lured Paul Allen to his apartment with one purpose in mind. Murder. Patrick's quirky diatribe is in complete contrast to his actions.
He's been compared to Elvis Costello, but I think Huey has a far more bitter, cynical sense of humor.
The tension mounts. We might expect an ominous soundtrack, but instead, he starts playing this.
In 87, Huey released this, Thor, their most accomplished album. I think their undisputed masterpiece is Hip to Be Square. A song so catchy, most people probably don't listen to the lyrics. But they should, because it's not just about the pleasures of conformity and the importance of trends. It's also a personal statement about the band itself. Hey, Paul!
Ah!
Stop getting his reservation at Dorsey now, you fucking stupid bastard!
The upbeat song creates a cognitive dissonance for viewers. The director, Mary Herron, places us in the gritty, murderous mind of Patrick Bateman and enhances the thrill with Huey Lewis's celebratory anthem. So when selecting when to use songs for tone, consider how you want the audience to feel and should your music align with the actions on screen or contrast it to create irony.
I love you. I love you.
To dive deeper into finding copyright-free music for your projects, check the description to learn about how the YouTube Music Library works. Next, you need to look at how the song connects to the characters. In opera, there is what is known as a leitmotif. A leitmotif in film is a recurring musical theme. That is often associated with either a character location or situation. Now, let's look at a much different film, Thor, Ragnarok.
Now.
Thor is at the top of his game, and there is an appropriately cool song to go over the sequence. The song does not appear again until the end of the film. Why is that? Throughout his journey, Thor goes through trials and tribulations that make him question his self-worth.
It's not possible.
It's not until the end of the film, when Thor regains his confidence with a newfound wisdom, that he becomes the true god of thunder. Thor's return to glory is a callback to the opening scene, and the song helps us make that connection. So when selecting what songs to use for your characters, consider what song fits your character's personality, and whether it could function in multiple scenes as a thematic cue. For our final case study, you must ask yourself if the song provides catharsis. Music has a way of bringing people together. Never overlook how the right song can alleviate the built-up anxiety forged by a story. Let's look at Almost Famous. Stillwater guitarist Russell Hammond,
I am a golden god!
Yeah! Has turned away everyone in his life.
Stop fucking looking at me!
His bandmates and friends are stuck on this bus, forced into proximity, but disconnected in every other way.
Blue jean baby, LA lady. For the band. Jesus free.
But then, one by one, each of his bandmates start singing this.
And then tickets are for gone. Turning back, she just laughs. The boulevard is not that bad.
This scene serves as a moment of unity and release. So when including the music in a moment of catharsis, consider if a track hits the correct emotional pitch at the apex of tension.
Where the hell did he come from?
I don't know.
Tonight, gonna have myself.
Well, who the hell put this on? Some random.
For fuck's sake.
Okay.
Before you put any song into a scene, you have to remember to consider the tone of the scene to make sure the song makes the audience feel how you want them to feel. Make sure the song connects to the characters and story elements in a meaningful way. Or provides catharsis for an audience that needs reprieve from conflict. With these elements, your needle drops will not only be fun to listen to, but will also serve the story. Make sure to subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon for notifications.